Thank you for the very kind introduction, Tracy. So please bear with me. I suddenly came down ill yesterday, so hopefully I will give you the energy that you deserve because you have been such a wonderful audience. But I'm going to tell you a story, and it's going to go back to when I was a little girl. And I know I look like I'm 13, but I'm not, I swear. You know, when I was a little girl, I used to dream of my wonderfully rich and just happy and fulfilling future. And when I say rich, I'm not talking about monetarily. I'm talking about my childhood dreams of cooking and baking in my own real oven, not my easy bake, if any of you guys still know what that old toy is. And I used to think about, you know, getting married, being a good wife, and if I had kids, being an awesome mother. Those were my pie in the sky, OMG, best life ever, I am winning type dreams. That was my reality that I was just bound to make come true. Or so I thought. About the time I was a freshman in high school, I had to go see my awesome guidance counselor. And when I say awesome, you know what I mean, because we all love our guidance counselors. And so I went to see him, and we talked about different things. He asked me a series of questions. He wanted to know my interests and what courses I wanted to take. And so, based on all my answers, we charted out my future. And with him, I scheduled my second semester courses. And I took the most challenging courses I could, and I loaded up on as many credits possible, because that's what I was supposed to do. So now let's fast forward a year later. I'm in my sophomore year, and I'm back in his office. And we're talking about the same things. We're reviewing my GPA. We're talking about my class ranking. We're talking about what choices I need to best impact my future and my college choices. And so a year later, I'm a little bit older and wiser. No, I was a lot older and wiser, I should say. I'm just joking, but seriously. You know, I had just come off from the most challenging courses I could think of. I had more credits than you could imagine, and I had a herniated disc from the 70-pound book bag that I carried every single day through my freshman year. But in my freshman year, I also learned about this practical vocational school that juniors and seniors attended, had they wanted to, for things like cosmetology, criminal justice, plumbing, carpentry, and to my delight, culinary arts. Here's my chance. Here's my chance, I say. I can start living my dream my junior year in high school. So as I'm enthusiastically telling my guidance counselor about my class choices and the career path I wanted to take, I look at his face. And I notice his facial expression. And he looks disappointed. And what follows out of his mouth confirmed my assumption. He said, "Shandra, no. You can't do that." And I said, "No, yes, I can." And he said, "No, you don't want to do that. You don't want to go to that school because that's for kids that aren't as smart or they don't want to take school seriously." So we go back and forth. We're going back and forth. He trying to tell me that it's not what I wanted to do and me telling him, yes, it was. In the end, I won. I enrolled in my culinary course. And the summer months leading into 11th grade, I fondly dreamt of my future. But when I left his office, I could not help that nagging little voice in my head that said, "Are you being stupid? Are other people going to think you're stupid because of the choices you're making? What if you're short-selling yourself? Are you living up to your potential?" And it kind of stayed there quietly. But now I'm in my first day of culinary class, junior year. I am excited. I am happy. "Here we go," I say. "You're starting your future. You're going to be a 5-star chef in one of the best kitchens in New York City. Here I go." But as the days and weeks wore on into the school year, and I learned 175 ways to make eggs, and I swear there are 175 ways to make eggs. As I made 87 different breakfast breads and every cookie known to man, I looked around and I said, "Oh, I don't want to admit this. I hate to admit it." He was right. These kids are idiots. They don't really want to be here. They just didn't want to be in a traditional, formal classroom setting. That's why they enrolled. And I just kept questioning to myself, "Wow, did you make the right decision? Are you taking the successful path? So senior year, I threw my dreams in the garbage. I enrolled in my practical courses that would ensure my success, and I took up business management classes in high school. But you know what? I was going to be able to say at my 10-year high school reunion that I am an absolute success. So I eagerly completed high school, making sure I took all those practical courses. And when I say eagerly, that's totally sarcastic. But I was making sure that I made the best choices to impact me, making sure that I'd be able to get my BS in business management. And as I was doing that, I was saying to myself, this is BS for sure. So the years rolled on, and I never actually got that BS in business management. But I also didn't venture into the culinary arts world either. But that's no surprise there, because you guys haven't seen me on Iron Chef just yet. I will be there, so look out for me. However, I did start to live my dream. I got married. I had two beautiful children. And much to my surprise, I started a business using my high school business management acumen. But about my fifth year in business, I realized I was miserable. And I kept saying to myself, why did you ignore your 15-year-old voice? Why did you ignore your 15-year-old self? Why didn't I listen to my gut? And then I realized I had become more consumed with wondering what other people thought about me, if I was really going to be able to say I was successful or not. I had lost listening to my voice, caring about the things that I care about as a young girl. I realized that as a child, the things that I dreamt about were things that I valued. They had qualities that were worth admiration. And I had my aha moment. I realized that I was more consumed with being considered awesome or a loser and being able to say I'm successful at my 10-year high school reunion than I cared about listening to the whispering voice of a 4-year-old that said, be valuable. So I decided that I really need to take a look at things. Go back to that innocent mind that had no comprehension of the adult secular view of things. And I thought about, how can I really run a business and grow a family and still show up saying, I'm successful? So I decided that I'm going to listen to the 4-year-old Shandra. And I'm going to be worth a great deal to those that care about me, develop qualities that are worth admiration, that my children can hold in high esteem. I'm going to be generous and kind, and I'm going to lead a journey where I leave a legacy built on the wealth of being an outstanding human being and not the wealth of my stock portfolio. My success will be determined by my value. You see, success is defined as a favorable termination of endeavors. And my endeavors or goals include being of value. See, I have an inherent need, you have an inherent need, we all do for that matter, to be of value and to be valued by others. So I decided a few years back that this is how I was going to live my life, by saying I was successful and contributing to society in a positive way. I would be successfully valuable, or as Aloe Black would say it, a little bit better.
Well, you can tell everybody, yeah, you can tell everybody, go ahead and tell everybody, I'm the man, I'm the man, I'm the man, yes I am, yes I am.
I ever told. Gave her every heart that I ever stole. Played my card.
That's my girl. That's my girl. That's my girl, Shandra. This is her.